What's up guys, it's Tommy here and I'm super excited because today we have a Liverpool player announcement video. Liverpool are signing one of the biggest attacking midfielder talents in English football and for a reported £1 million transfer fee, which could rise to £3 million. The player is a Derby County huge talent and Wayne Rooney said some very good words about him, saying that he's the best trainer that he has seen on the training pitch in his career, and he is only 16 years old. But the reason why we are targeting him is because of Brexit, Liverpool aren't allowed to sign players from abroad who are younger than 18 years old. And according to the Telegraph journalist John Percy, this transfer is already done and dusted, only the final details are being ironed out. So there will be an official announcement on Liverpool FC's official website in the next few days, and the transfer fee could rise to £3 million. And in this video you will get to know all you need to know about Kyle Gordon, a very talented attacking midfielder that Liverpool are about to sign. And if you are excited about Liverpool signing another player, leave a like and subscribe if you are new to my channel and turn on the bell notification so you never miss the latest uploads. So John Percy, who is a respectable journalist working for the Telegraph newspaper, saying that Liverpool are closing in on the signing of Kyle Gordon from Derby County. A deal for Gordon is £1 million guaranteed, but with bonuses and add-ons, that fee could rise to £3 million. He didn't sign yet, but that the transfer is heading that way. An attacking midfielder, Gordon is seen as one of the best of his age, and the youngster is in fine form for Derby's under 18 side. So far, he scored 3 goals in 5 appearances, and like Harvey Elliott, Gordon is left-footed and often plays left wing, where it's expected that he will be developed for the Liverpool under 18 side, and he could join the first team very soon. Peter O'Rourke, who is also a journalist, sports journalist, said that Liverpool have agreed a deal for Derby youngster Kyle Gordon, and the move is expected to be done in the next 48 hours, and Gordon is one of the best talents in his age group. He is as big a talent as Harvey Elliott. Remember that we signed Harvey Elliott when he was just 15 years old from Fulham, and now he's on loan at Blackburn, only 17, still even like high school age, and he's already one of the best players in the Championship. He's one of the best assist guys, and given these troubled financial times during the pandemic, the rumored £3 million is a serious commitment from Liverpool, and that shows how highly the Liverpool scouts rate Gordon. And let's hope that Kyle Gordon develops at the rate that Harvey Elliott does, because Harvey Elliott is just 17, and at Blackburn he has 4 goals and 8 assists in the Championship. And if Liverpool do seal this transfer for Gordon, then they could look to handle him in a similar way to Elliott. Gordon could spend the second half of this season in Liverpool's youth setup to help him get used to the life in Liverpool, meet the staff at the club, and then it could even work out that Liverpool could even send Gordon on loan to Blackburn as a replacement for Elliott if Jurgen Klopp decides in the summer that Elliott is a first team option at Anfield, or maybe if Harvey Elliott deserves a Premier League loan. Liverpool need to get this deal over the line to start with, and then they can start planning his path through the first team until the first team. And this is what Wayne Rooney, the current Derby County manager, said. Wayne Rooney just retired recently after being player manager earlier this season, and now he's just the manager for Derby County. He said, "Kyle Gordon is a fantastic player and he has got a lot of potential. He has come through the academy, he's 16 years old, he has got a lot of development to do, and he's definitely at the right place to do that. Of course there will be interest in Kyle because he is a fantastic player, so we expect there to be interest in him. We can control what we are doing at this football club, but we can't control if other teams make bids for our players." And Derby County are in a tough financial position, so that's one of the reasons why they basically had to accept that guaranteed £1 million cash injection from Liverpool. And because Liverpool can't sign players from abroad who are younger than 18, they are now targeting young English players who can come in and become world class. I mean, Harvey Elliott is on his way to become world class, and he also cost very little money for Liverpool, and Liverpool targeting the future great stars of English football, I think, is absolutely fantastic. So what is also important is that Gordon will be joining Liverpool on a youth deal. He cannot sign a professional contract until his 17th birthday, but that is this October, so he doesn't have to wait too long. And Gordon made his debut for Derby County in the 4-0 win away at Birmingham City earlier this month, and he became the club's fourth youngest ever player. And Wayne Rooney, of course, praised him, which I already told you about. And even though Kyle Gordon hasn't played a lot of first team football in the senior team, Wayne Rooney was praising for his player for working hard and showing plenty of ability to go far in the game of football. I brought Cade up to the first team initially to train with us for a week to see how he reacted to it, and he was one of the best trainers. I kept him with us for a couple of weeks, and he has been training at the same level, if not to a better level, to a lot of the other first team players. As I said to the players, if you train hard and if you train well, I will give you your chance, and Kyle Gordon deserves it. Those are the words of Wayne Rooney, who is a very, very experienced manager, he was a very experienced player, so he knows a thing or two about ability, and he sees plenty of ability in Kyle Gordon, which is really, really encouraging for Liverpool. And Mike McGrath, another journalist who wrote an article in the Telegraph, said that Liverpool are about to beat Manchester United and Tottenham to the signature of Kyle Gordon, because Man United and Tottenham were also interested in this very, very highly talented, highly rated young player. And Kyle Gordon is already a versatile player because he's left-footed. He can play on the left wing, he can play on the right wing to cut inside, but he can even play through the middle. And Kyle Gordon is a versatile option. He already scored a hat-trick for Derby against Blackburn in the under 18 Premier League, and it's easy to search those stats for this season and see Gordon as the typical outside forward who only hunts for goals. But there's much more to Kyle Gordon's game. He's a fine dribbler. The 16-year-old is dangerous when running at defenders with superb close control, making it difficult to get the ball off him. Combine that with sharp dribbling with a killer final pass in key areas, and you have Gordon, which is why his stock is so high and which is why the Liverpool scouts have identified him as the next great English star to come through. He has already shown composure and the ability to pass through the lines, indicating he has a good footballing brain on him. Throw in a bit of physicality and it's easy to see why he's highly thought of. And the Premier League scout described Kyle Gordon as the best 16-year-old in England right now. Gordon is already in the national team setup, having represented England at youth level. He is a regular with the under-16s. Gordon scored on his debut, and the move to Liverpool will only raise his profile and help him knock on the door of higher age groups. But I still think that Liverpool have to sign a centre-back this month, either on loan or as a free transfer if we don't have money for a really, really good centre-back right now on a permanent deal. And some Liverpool fans agree with me, because on Twitter the reaction to this Kyle Gordon transfer has been very mixed. One fan said, why are Liverpool desperately trying to sign kids instead of a centre-back or a centre-attacking midfielder? Kids are where the owners see value, a fellow Liverpool fan replied. Rather than buying for the now, they are only thinking about selling in the future. So we are willing to sign a kid, but not a centre-back. I thought we were skint, we were broke. That's another fan's reaction. And I love this sarcastic comment by another Liverpool fan. Yes, another teenager being signed. We are ready for the 2030-31 Premier League and Champions League season. I love the scouts' sense of humor. Another Liverpool fan said, buy for cheap, sell for profit, FC. That's what Liverpool have come to. Another fan sarcastically said, League One, which means that Liverpool will win the Premier League with Kyle Gordon. We just don't know when. I love these reactions by the Liverpool fans. And even the mouthpieces of Liverpool FC, the journalists who usually report on Liverpool's things, James Pearce, Melissa Reddy and Paul Gorst of Liverpool Echo, said that Liverpool owners will make a huge mistake if they don't sign a centre-back in in this winter transfer window. And I think this verdict is spot on. Paul Gorse said the fact that Jurgen Klopp has been expected to continue to keep Liverpool as England's dominant side in the middle of the biggest injury crisis without the reinforcements, the signings that Jurgen Klopp has readily admitted he wants, he would like, is borderline negligence from the owners. Only they will know how tightly wound finances are right now. Given their prudent ownership over the last 10 years, they will no doubt see it as a sensible leadership. But while a stopgap mid-season centre-back continues to go begging, the Liverpool are losing significant ground on other teams. Should the same problems rear their head at Spurs, it could be curtains for the defence of the Premier League title. It really is that grave a situation. The relatively small financial rewards of the FA Cup are unlikely to force a shock rethink, but the game's biggest prizes, the Premier League, the Champions League, and the millions that Liverpool could lose, could be out of sight within weeks at this rate. Jurgen Klopp has made it crystal clear he's not getting what he craves this January transfer window. Even at their lowest, Klopp's Liverpool have proven they have the stomach for the fight, and you know, it just took a free kick from Bruno Fernandes to knock Liverpool out of the FA Cup. And a club with ambitions as high as Liverpool, we should not be heading into the final week of the transfer window in this current shape, that we have just one fit senior centre-back and inexperienced kids who are Championship League One level. The real concern is that it will take more than an FA Cup exit for those in power to realise it, and by that time, it might be too late. If we lose to Tottenham, our title defense is definitely over, and we will have a very, very, very hard battle on our hands for the top four. The only way I can see Liverpool being in the title race is if we beat Tottenham, and then if we go on a winning run and win 5, 6, 7 games in a row. That's what it would take for Liverpool to close the massive 7-point gap back on Manchester City, because if Man City beat West Brom, which I fully expect them to, then they will be 7 points ahead of Liverpool, and that is a lot. That is a lot, especially against the Man City team, who with John Stones and Ruben Dias, they only conceded one goal in like 9 or 10 games. And Liverpool's defense is actually not that bad in the Premier League. It's just going forward, our goals have dried up, and Liverpool have to figure something out. We have to sign a centre-back, otherwise I don't see Liverpool winning the Premier League, winning the Champions League, and then ultimately the season will be a failure. If we only finish in the top four and have no trophies to show for it, then the season is a failure, and that will be on the owners and their reluctance to back Jurgen Klopp, the most successful Liverpool manager of the past like 30 years. And Jordan Henderson, the Liverpool captain, very well explained Liverpool's current problems, and he suggested there is light at the end of the tunnel. Let's just hope it's not a train about to knock Liverpool out of the title race and the Champions League. One of our great strengths as a team, Henderson said, in the last few years is that we don't dwell on previous games, whether they have been good, bad, or indifferent. What we have done, though, is take any lessons we have learned and put them into practice. This is something that is particularly important during the current period when we are looking to get back to our best. We know we are not firing on all cylinders at the moment. Goals are not coming as freely as we would like them to. Games are becoming more difficult as a result. This is a team issue, not an attack problem. Because one thing that the Klopp has always drummed into us ever since he has been here is that we are all responsible for everything. Every single one of us is responsible for the team scoring goals, and every single one of us is responsible for the team not scoring goals. It's that simple. This approach has always served us well, and we will not deviate from it. I'm well aware that outside of the club, there will be those who justifiably at the moment will be critical of our form, and we'll always look at areas of the team and individuals who they feel could do better. This isn't the path that we will go down. And Jordan Henderson is spot on, and Liverpool have to climb out of this slump, otherwise we can kiss goodbye the Premier League title and maybe even the top four. But let's hope that's not the case. the Tottenham-Liverpool game is massive, but I've been saying that for a month, that the next game is massive, and Liverpool have just one win in seven games, and that was against the Aston Villa on the 23s, so this is probably the worst run of Jurgen Klopp's Liverpool since like 2016. Let's hope we can climb out of it. Come on, Liverpool, let's beat Tottenham on Thursday. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. Have a nice day. See you later. Goodbye.